Hi everybody and welcome to another Bitwig Studio video. How do you like your basses? Do you like them natural or do you like them boiled? My name is Mattias and I like my basses roasted, so let's take the tour. So here we have Bitwig Studio 3, it's the beta version number 4. And now you're wondering, what do I mean with roasting the bass or boiling the bass? Well, when you're creating Reese basses, these really low and deep rumbling basses, it can be hard for them to come out on smaller speakers and laptops and mobile phones. And that's why you usually add some kind of saturation to the basses to give it a little bit of top end. And that's what I call roasting or boiling the bass. Okay, so let's listen to the drop here. Okay, so this bass, we can listen to this in solo. This is a bass that I created with Serum. It's just this PVM C64 wavetable with 8 voices, unison. And then we have a second oscillator with the same PVM C64. But this is just a single oscillator. And then we have set them set to -2 octaves. And we have a quite heavy filtering going on. So we have this deep rumble. We can listen to this in solo. So what we want to do with this bass is give it a little bit of a grit and upper harmonics so we can get this bass to come through on smaller speakers. And what I did here is in Bitwig 3, this is the beta 4, you have something called the effect grid. So I've been talking about overdrives and saturations in Bitwig before, and previously we have only had access to some half-decent overdrives, but now with the effect grid we can use a whole set here of different wave shapers that we can mess up the signal and make some nice saturation and overdrive with. So what have I done here? Well, we have the audio input that's going into this effect grid device. Then it goes to a distortion device, which is quite heavily shaping the wave here, the waves. Then I'm taking the signal and going into this stereo split to split the signal. Because what I want to do is take the low end and just let the low end come through natural as it is. But then I want to send a separate signal to a high pass filter. And with the high pass filter, we will add a rectifier, so that the top end will get this crisp grittiness. And that's what I'm doing here. The left and right channel is going to this mixer. Then I'm sending the stereo signal from this split to the high pass. And I'm high passing at 1.2 kHz. Then this goes to the rectifier, which is this shaper, the rectifier. And here we can drag this minus pole upwards. And then we get some really nasty upper range grittiness. Just listen here. So now we only hear this upper gritty range. And this is the normal or distorted low end part. So I can put a link to this device in the description to this video if you want to download this saturator and try it out for yourself in Bitwig 3. We could of course also use a polysynth as the bass, but I wanted to use this Serum one, because I came up with this nice set of wavetable that I think sounded very nice. But the same thing goes with this polysynth. And disable. That's the unboiled bass. And then the boiled bass. I think it sounds a lot better, and it will come out on smaller speakers too. And if you have Trash 2, that's a really great plugin. I use this Saturator all the time, also to warm up and boil the basses. But I think that this Saturator with the effect grid sounded really nice. I will make another video on the other sounds in this track. We can look at the cinematic pads and how I created the leads. And yeah, some of these distant moans and other effects in this track. Okay, so that's how easy it is to create saturated basses with Bitwig Studio 3. If you have any questions on this video or creating basses, please shoot them in the comment section below. Now let's listen to this little music cue, and we will call it a day. See you in the next video. Bye! Yeah, so that's all for today. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.